Today, we will discuss how the continents and the oceans are different. Let's start with the oceans. The oceans have thin crust, and they're composed principally of basalt and gabbro. And there's a large mountain range in the center of many of the oceans, like the Mid-Atlantic Ridge. Why is there a mountain range there? Well, that's a divergent plate boundary where hot magma is coming up and is adding crust. Heat rises, it causes the mountain range to be high. We also have ocean trenches. These are the deepest locations in the ocean, and they occur at subduction zones. Remember, where one plate goes underneath another plate. Now, these trenches are deep because of the subduction zone, but that's also a big hole, and it tends to fill with sediment. And one of the most important types of sediment is called a turbidity current. It's a density current composed of sediment and water that moves downslope. And there's actually a very interesting story about how we recognized the importance of turbidity currents. And it came from a study of the 1929 Grand Banks earthquake off the northeastern part of the United States. In the 1950s, several geologists studied the records from the 1929 Grand Banks earthquake. In 1929, if you wanted to call someone in England, you did it over a cable that stretched across the Atlantic Ocean. And there were phone operators always on these cables, constantly connecting people back and forth. Well, after the 1929 earthquake, a lot of those cables broke, and we lost the connection. And the operators always noted the time. Well, the geologists in the 1950s looked at those records, and what they noted was that the cables that were in shallow water broke first, and the ones that were in deeper water broke later. So they hypothesized that an underwater current, a density current, had moved downslope and broke the cables sequentially. They then went out and tested that idea by collecting cores in the area in deeper water from where the cables broke. And what they found was a graded bed of sand. It went from coarse sand to fine sand to mud. And they interpreted that as a density flow deposit, which they called a turbidity current, which is one way that sand gets out into deeper water. Well, let's talk about another type of deposit. Let's talk about atolls. Atolls are circular islands that are found in nice, warm, tropical climates, like in the Southwest Pacific. They form above an extinct volcano. As the volcano cools down, it sinks. But the corals in reefs want to stay in shallow water, so they grow up. So what happens is you produce a circular ring of islands, but there's an old volcano deep underneath it. Now let's talk about the continents. The continents have thicker crust than the oceans, and the average composition is granite. Now there's one interesting thing about continents. If you look at the edge of the continents, some of the continents have very steep and narrow continental shelves, like out in California. These are called active margin continental shelves. They're above subduction zones or along transform fault margins. On the other hand, some shelves are very broad and gentle, like on the east coast of the United States. These are called passive continental margins. There's not a subduction zone there. Continents contain the oldest rocks on the Earth. The oceans are much younger. Why? Well, it's all about subduction. All of the old oceanic crust has been subducted, and it's gone, so we don't have any old oceanic crust.